Center stage here at the Tianhe Gymnasium in Guangzhou. Badminton World Championships. The winner of the women's singles has come from China on 15 occasions over those last 17 championships. But this is history in the making, because our Ratchanok Intanon, at just 18 years of age, she's still eligible for the Junior World Championships. It's the first ever player from Thailand to appear in the World Championship final. Of course, Thailand have two bronze medals from the same pair in the mixed doubles, 2005-2006, Sukhet and Sarin won bronze medals, but this first player from Thailand to be in the World Championship final. Just 18 years of age. Well, of course, it was not an all-Chinese final at the last World Championships, because Chen Xiaoxie from Chinese Taipei, 2007, Wang Chen, who had been born and bred here in China but representing Hong Kong. But how healthy is that? Four different nations that were represented at semi-final stage, six different nations, including Spain, first ever Spaniard in a quarter-final of a World Championships in the form of the left-hander, Carolina Marin. The women's singles discipline is the most exciting discipline in world terms in world badminton at the moment. Emergence of so many good young players, and they are really challenging the dominance of China in women's singles discipline. World ranking of number one, and that's quite understandable for the Olympic champion. This her fourth final of the year. Won the Indonesia Superseries. She's lost in two other finals. But look at her route through to today's final. She hasn't dropped a game. And that despite that quarterfinal against number six seed Tyson Yun, another very, very talented teenager from Chinese Taipei. She was 12-18 down in the second game, in the first game, and saved two game points. Well, our Ratchanok Intanon gone up two places in the world ranking, and that's without this tournament's results going towards the world ranking. Up two places to number three, and you can see that her quarterfinal against the left-handed Carolina Marin from Spain had three match points actually in the second game to win in two straight games. But the fighting spirit of the Spaniard was quite incredible. Won her semi-final against the number two seed PV Sindhu of India, and mention should be made of Sindhu because she beat the reigning world champion in the last 16, followed up with victory over the reigning Asian Games gold medalist in the quarterfinal to reach the semi-final. First Indian woman to pick up a medal in the singles event of the World Championships. Of course, 2 years ago, Indian women got a bronze medal in the women's doubles, Dwala Gutta and Ashwini Ponnapa. Well, Xuerui, only 22 years of age herself.
Ladies and gentlemen, on my right, Xuerui, China. Ratchanok Intanon, Thailand. Ratchanok Intanon to serve, level play.
World Championship final. The 18-year-old number 4 seed Ratchanok Intanon against the Olympic champion from China. What a good opening rally. Brilliant opening rally. Well, I have to say, Steam, both these players in their semi-finals yesterday, Lee Xuerui against the left-handed Korean Bae Yong-ju, two straight games, 21-5, 21-11. And this lady, as I was saying, against Sindhu, 21-10, 21-13. So they were very, very impressive in their semi-finals. This is a different prospect though, isn't it?
Yeah, I'm really excited to see the first game because I thought Xuerui was kind of nervous against Su Ying Tai in the quarterfinal and were in big problems, but managed to save the game and then cruise to victory in the second. So I feel it's very important for Ratchanok Intanon to take this first game into taking the world title.
It was very interesting what she was saying afterwards, after her semi-final victory. She said, well, all the pressure's going to be on Lee Xuerui. She's the one playing in front of her home fans. She's the one that's the Olympic champion. I can play free.
Yeah, it's quite funny because almost every player is so quick to sort of try to put the pressure on the opponent.
Yeah.
Wouldn't it be a relief if some player came up and said, well, there's an enormous amount of pressure on me and it's really challenging. I love this. I'm going to give my best. I'm going to be nervous, but I'm going to give my best anyway.
So the solo, 3-2.
Just going for precision.
Service solo, 3-4.
And Steve, what should we as the spectators, the fans, be looking for in this match? To me, the outstanding thing about these two players is their skill level.
Yeah, they both have a very high skill level, but anyway, I still see it as a little bit of the natural player against the hard-working player. There's nothing wrong with hard work, don't get me wrong. It's just, you could also say, the more playful player against the more efficient player.
Playful player being Ratchanok?
Yeah, definitely. Even though both players are very skillful, I regard Ratchanok as more skillful stroke-wise than Lee Xuerui. But in order to capitalize from that, she has to be very, very effective and hard-working as well. I think Xuerui has a bit more speed. She has a bit better reach. As far as I can see, she's a bit higher than than Intanon without sort of having any problems with being too high. And she can play Xuerui, she can play different kinds of playing styles. She can play attacking, and she can play patient, and she can play controlling. So I hold her as a favorite because these extra skills, touch, super deceptions, good look for angles. All these skills that Ratchanok has needs to be backed up by speed and consistency. Earlier I had some doubts whether she was going to, this immensely talented player, if she was going to be able to challenge the Chinese as a senior, but well, that's what gone. She was in the All England final,
yep,
and now she's in the World Championship final, so she's for real, no doubt about that.
Yeah.
I think the chance today is to take the first game and put the pressure on Li Xuerui here in front of a home crowd.
Long of the back line.
9-6.
Four straight points for the number four seed.
Good shot.
Chinese coaches. Nice to see her back coaching. This is her first event back as a coach since the birth of her baby daughter.
Yeah, that could also be a factor because with the coaching chair, Jiang Ni, she really knows how to win big championships and they've not won these big championships. And with being in this final, actually, Ratchanok is the most achieving player of Thailand. There's never been anyone else in the World Championship final. So when she leaves this court today, she will have the biggest experience of all in Thailand.
Twice Olympic champion. And eight, and of course won the world title exactly 10 years ago in Birmingham. And that experience of having won these big titles, it's the understanding of knowing what your player is going through and how they'll be feeling, the nerves. Yeah.
And it's not only Jiang Ning, because the guy sitting next to her is even more experienced because he's been coaching all these ladies singles, Jiang Ning, Wang Yihan, before that, Dai Yun, I forgot the name of the others, but he's been there for ages and so experienced.
Well, that run of points comes to an end. It had been five straight points from 6-9 back to go to the interval at 11-9 up, the Olympic champion.
Meters that the shuttles seem to drift away.
Just across the body. To think that 2 years ago, Li Xuerui didn't even qualify for the World Championships. Since then, of course, become Olympic champion.
It's really good quality in her shots. Exactly the right height, the right speed, and doesn't leave time for Ratchanok to do anything.
Camera with a light on. That must have been distracting for the players. We know that the net play is absolutely vital in men's singles. And do you think it's going to be a big influence on the outcome of this match? Who can control the net area? Well, not as much as men's singles.
I can see that Ratchanok is not attacking as much as we saw Tsuying Tai do when she played Li Xuerui. Sort of leaves the initiative with Xuerui. Ratchanok not really able to put pressure on her shots to the baseline because of the drift. You can see that she has to play a lot of high quality shots to get a winner. 16. And I feel that Li Xuerui is a bit better than Ratchanok doing that. Sometimes there's a loose shot from Ratchanok, and it doesn't mean that much against most of the other players she's playing, but against Li Xuerui, it might be because she will just get back into the rally. Too short. Taking a small opportunity, making it bigger and bigger without any risk of being counter-attacked, and then she's able to kill it here. Very, very safe point for Li Xuerui.
Balance. played with disguise.
Ratchanok has to look for possibilities of sort of neutralizing the pressure from Li Xuerui. Ratchanok is able to apply a little bit more of pressure in the basic game. I think it'll be hard for her because I think we'll see Li Xuerui come out attacking a bit more from that side of the court.
Some commentary for our colleagues in the local network. Wang Xin, of course, had to retire injured from the Olympic bronze medal playoff match against Sina Nawal.
She had a match against Ratchanok in the quarterfinals where she was in really dire straits. Tensed.
She's again in 16-9 down against this unit stuff in Thailand. Came back. It's going right.
There's been a couple of loose shots, especially from her backhand side, mid-court backhand side. It's been a little bit loose from Xuerui.
Five straight points, and now there's only 2 points in it. Steady the nerves. It was now 3 game point opportunities. At 20-all, we will require extra points until there's a clear 2-point winning margin. And the umpire allowing the Olympic champion Ning Xuerui to have a little towel down. And the court is mopped of the perspiration.
It's a very surprising development to me in this first game.
Yeah, 8 of 9 points from 12-19 down. Wow. Intanon has a game point herself.
And the Xuerui, she has to try to attack because she's not standing her defense right now.
Was possible to come back in that opening game. Well, isn't that the beauty of sports? Anything is possible. Game number one to the number four seed from Thailand.
What happened?
Well, she's been there before, has coach Zhang Ning. Seen it all before, but I wonder if that's, she's just as astonished at that as you and me, Steen. Just before the coaches had the opportunity to talk to their players, he said to me, what on earth happened? 12-19 down, 3 game points down, and she comes back and wins. Yeah. Intanon.
It was like it wasn't the same player on court anymore. And Ratchanok seemed to loosen up. And I really feel that it's her chance now. She needs to maintain that psychological pressure on Li Xuerui. That's good.
Smiling. That may be a ploy to try and relax herself.
Yeah, that's good. Nice. That's good.
Well, she made history, Ratchanok Intanon, by becoming the first player to win 3 consecutive World Junior titles. Made history becoming the youngest ever finalist at the All England Championships. and we're pretty certain if she was to win here, she'd be the youngest ever world champion. But we can't get ahead of ourselves, nor can she.
She doesn't really know Ratchanok. Was it in or should she have left it? What's the point anyway?
That's a great angle. I know you've already talked about the skills, Steen, but the other thing I want to mention is their movement, both of them. They're light on their feet. I described it the other day as balletic, so like a ballet dancer, that seems to make their movement and dance look effortless.
Yeah. Wow. Just one step backwards before reaching it this one. It's long and long. Very important that it's also long.
Three, four.
For Intanon, because that gives her a clue of the length of the shots from Xuerui. It's a very difficult corner to put pressure on, the backhand corner of Ratchanok Intanon now, because the drift is coming from right to left and from Xuerui towards Intanon, and it's almost impossible to control the shots to that corner. So time might be looking for intercepting in the other corner.
Must be very, very careful. Surely she's realized the drift. Trying to go for that cross-court winner. Playing with the wind is very dangerous indeed. Well, we had a glimpse there of at least one Thai supporter in the crowd here. That's super play. She was talking to one of our colleagues in the written media yesterday, was Ratchanok Intanon, and she was saying that it really will make a huge difference to her family. She's been given this wonderful opportunity to play badminton and supported by the federation. And
she was also getting a Twitter message from PV Sindhu, whom she beat in the semi-final.
Oh, how nice.
And Sindhu wished her good luck and hoping that she would take the title so she wouldn't regret so much.
For the last non-Chinese player, there she is, there's PV Sindhu. Last and the other semi-finalist, Bei Yongju. Last player to win the women's singles at the World Championship who didn't come from China. He was, of course, a Dane. Camilla Martin. 1999. Prior to that, go back to 1993 and Susie Susanti. Problem for Liu Xuerui. Losing confidence, or possibility she would lose confidence about playing attacking clears to the back of the court, having seen a couple of drift long now.
That's what happens, or might be happening, that Ratchanok can intercept and using these sort of flip-flops that's where I think she's a bit more skillful, these speciality shots, compared to Xuerui. That's pretty skillful.
Phenomenal. So now, of course, the Olympic champion, do you dare to play back to the net? Do you dare to play deep? You've hit long, you've tried a good net shot, you're beaten at the net. What does she try?
Just small adjustments. She needs to find the baseline. So when trying for it, she has to be alert on the front court. Great shot there.
And don't panic.
I think Ratchanok should be very alert on her forehand side, because there will be a lot of shots directed there, and then some shots once in a while to the backhand, but not a lot, because it would be too risky. Janine just directing Xuerui, wanting her to do things a little bit different there. Perhaps put a little deception on before lifting to prevent it from going out. So if she can play it with a margin, it could be a very, very good shot for her. Thank you. It all comes from not being afraid of the drift, but in some manner seeing it as your friend.
There seems to be some sort of indication about these little angle shots that you were talking about, Steen, whether that's beware of your opponent playing them or try and intercept the flatter clears, and that little flick drop that you described, even that's when you just flick the racket head over the top of the shuttle to bring it down so steeply. Three straight points for the Chinese player.
I have a feeling we're going to see Xuerui playing smash, keep net, smash, keep net.
Oh.
Ratchanok Intanon. She also thanked her coach for the coaching in between, or the interval coaching. And I mean, I've never seen any other player do that. Now the net play comes into action, Jill, like you said, because it's going to be a battle for the attack.
Yes. Second game.
The game is close and you're a bit tensed and you tend to overdo it because you just don't want to play any more shots. You just want some points. What's keeping her in this game? Three mistakes from Xuerui. She's the one with the initiative at the moment.
That time the judgment is sound. It drifts long at the back line. Yes, and a very concerned head coach Lee Yongbo.
You can almost see the relief when Xu realizes that it's the winner.
Yeah.
Oh, thank you. I don't have to play anymore. Ratchanok should be aware that with 90% possibility, if Lee Xuerui is lifting, she's lifting to the forehand because she won't have to worry about the side drift.
Short. Good defense.
She's about to take the second game.
Yeah.
problem for Ratchanok is that she simply takes the shuttle too low at the net. She takes it late. She's used to playing that style, but it won't work for her now. She needs to put pressure on Li Xuerui. And therefore she has to take the shuttle high so that she can make quite flat lifts to the backcourt, preventing Li Xuerui from keep attacking or keep putting pressure on her. Whereas Li Xuerui, she's got the tactic spot on. It's just a matter of if she can keep the shuttle inside the lines. To the net if she wants to play tight net shots. Four points away from a world title.
Oh, that was game five, was it? Game point opportunities for Li Xuerui, but remember she led 2017 in the opening game and failed to convert.
So very experienced, doing an excellent job here.
Still game point opportunity. Oh, no, 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 you've just been toweling down. What on earth's going on? Still game point to Li Xuerui. Badminton, and the Olympic champion holding her nerve. It is one game all, their confirmation, and everything to play for in the third and deciding game.
但不要着急，你只是个配合你的这个进攻，不要跟他硬抽。你看这边我都往前老是趴在那打，其实挺好的，只要抢到了，他一直在打挺好的，自信一点。后面别跟他使劲抽就好了，他肯定还是要攻的很多，往前也是这种你抢了以后注意他的推的就够了啊，没问题，他不会拨你，放心啊。
20 seconds.
The call of 20 seconds remaining from the umpire is a clear signal for the players to return to court. And Steen, I can't help but flash back to that rally when it was 15-16. And the youngster from Thailand had at least three opportunities to put the shuttle away, but failed to do so. And so the score moved 17-15 in favour of Xuerui.
Yeah, a really important rally.
Yeah.
She managed to create the gap she needed to take the game.
Short. Yeah, it was similar sort of rally to that in that the opportunities to put the shuttle away.
Yeah, it's 10 rallies late.
Yeah. Oh, that serve was going long. Oh, that's incredible. I mean, how she creates some of those angles, both at the overheads and at the net, it's just astonishing.
Yeah, and in my mind, the most technical, skillful player we've ever had. The only one who comes close to her would be Mia Audina from Indonesia and the Netherlands. I would still choose Ratchanok as his best technical player.
And she probably hasn't even finished her development on her skills and technique at the age of 18.
It's a strong comeback here, leading 5-1 in the third.
Yeah.
I mean, I would have expected Xuerui to sort of have the upper hand now. Answering back, coaches, well, it's not working, that's wide. Good shot.
Super angle. Goodness me. Well, we've just been talking about how she can create angles almost out of nothing.
And the problem for Xuerui is that she's not really getting anything back at the moment. Sometimes you feel like the Chinese go into survival mode where they just run and get everything back.
That's right. Once again. Xuerui isn't convinced by the call, but we've got a wonderful sight looking straight down that line. And I'm in agreement with the line judge. Nice. going wide. Well, she's obviously been told to play deep into the round the head or backhand corner of Ratchanok.
That's the safe corner. But wasn't enough to help Ratchanok inside the lines.
Oh, the Olympic champion desperately needs to close this deficit down before the change of ends. First, then
she's loosened up a little bit, Xuerui now.
Well,
a bit lucky as well, because that might as well have stayed on her own side, and then it would be 9-6 and momentum on Xuerui's side. Now trying to go to the interval with a big lead.
That's brilliant. Oh my goodness, she's got it back.
Xuerui is back in the game. Excellent.
This time she was waiting for the net reply. So it's a 4-point advantage at the change of ends in the deciding game for the number 4 seed, Ratchanok Intanon. The big question in my mind, Steen, is can she hold her nerve? She's got to put the enormity of the situation out of her mind, and, you know, the old cliche, one point at a time, but she really does have to do that.
She knows what's going to happen, because the same thing, like we saw in the second game, is going to happen now, because there are no other solutions for Xuerui playing that side of the court.
So by that you mean she's going to attack, net shot.
And play some flat lift to the forehand corner of Intanon.
Yeah.
Perhaps also, if she dares, a few attacking shots to her backhand side to keep the forehand side open. But Intanon needs to go step forward, reach the tight spinning net shot a bit higher so that she can sort of overplay, by that I mean lifting flat, so that Xuerui will have to return from a defensive position to overplay Xuerui from the net.
Perfect smash.
and precision.
To use from the long, deep forehand, because that is so important now. For instance, a hard flat shot to the body of Li Xuerui would be nice.
Good lift.
There it was, the overplay.
Sense that.
They know that as well. Either it's a one-point game or you open up a three-point gap. So and it was the first rally where Intanon sort of came back in it after changing the sides.
Yeah. Well, she's literally wringing the perspiration out of her dress there. Li Xuerui.
Players that emerges world champion will never get nervous in the same way anymore than a world championship. That's a good shot from Intanon. I like to put speed in it because it gives Li Xuerui less time to react and thereby less choices. Just about a big enough lead to make her a little bit nervous again.
Yeah, 5-point advantage now. Big high serve. Attendance being asked to come on to court virtually every other rally. We're second shy of the hour mark in this match.
To play the short net cross from her backhand, I feel that would be a great shot. Short.
Well,
Xuerui, she knows that Intanon is more likely to play in her backhand corner. So she's really alert, and that has given her two easy points.
And now there's just 2 points in it. That's loose.
Impossible to do anything else than just return it straight.
Yeah. 16-12.
Service fault point from Intanon.
4 points away from the world title for the number 4 seed, Ratchanok Intanon. Errors.
I still feel Li Xuerui has got a chance.
Yeah, so do I.
A lot of nerves in this match.
Points required for history to be made.
That was going to go wide as well.
youngest ever world champion. The first from her country. A first world championship that we've had four players from four different nations in the semi-final. And it is only the third time since Chinese players contested the World Championships that a player other than a Chinese player has won the women's singles world title. The moment of victory for Ratchanok Intanon. 22-20, 18-21, and 21-14 in the deciding game in an hour and 5 minutes. History has just been made. We'll be right back. So to the prize presentation for the women's singles. Four players from four different nations will stand on the podium. PV Sindhu of India and Bei Yongzhu on the left hander. All four medalists, 22 years of age or younger. Her first world championships in Xuerui, a silver medal to go with her gold Olympic medal. The Vice President of Asia and BWF, presenting the bronze medals, first of all, including Sindhu. And Kartak Sindhu, to give her a full name. The number one seed, Li Xuerui, gracious in defeat. And she was a huge contributing factor to such a wonderful women's singles final today. But the world champion is the 18-year-old Ratchanok Intanon of Thailand. 下面有请广州市副市长赛事组委会执行主任王东为获奖运动员。Who defeated the number three seed Simon Awell in the quarterfinal. If we were going to put money on an Indian getting a medal at these world championships, it probably would have been Simon Awell, but Pusala Venkata Sindhu has had the most remarkable tournaments, defeating the reigning world champion. So to the trophy, to add to the flowers and the gold medal. Ratchanok Intanon is the world champion. Two finals so far, and history has been made in both of them. First time we've ever had a player win three consecutive gold medals in the women's doubles. Yu Young achieving that. And now in the women's singles, a youngest ever champion and the first ever world champion from Thailand. This is a young lady we're going to see so much more of over the years. And what a joy she is to watch. Women's singles and the world of badminton is in a very healthy situation.
So after that thrilling women's singles, we turn our attention now to mixed doubles and the number one seeds, Chuchen and Margin. The Olympic silver medalists up against Tontoi Akhmad and Liliana Natsir, the number three seeds from Indonesia. Liliana Natsir appearing in her fourth World Championship.